So how did the Master Gardener program come about, and how many Master Gardeners are there?
The Master Gardener program began in 1972 at Washington State University. It's a national program. Extension agents found that they were getting lots and lots of questions from homeowners about home gardening. And so they put out an advertisement and asked if there were avid gardeners who were interested in answering people's questions. And they trained them, started what we call the core course, and in 1977, Minnesota and 9 other states also adopted that program. And in Minnesota here, we're celebrating our 35th anniversary, and we have approximately just under about 2,600 active Master Gardeners in Minnesota.
Wow.
Yeah, it's a big, big group.
So tell me a little bit about the garden we're sitting in right now.
This is the Department of Horticultural Science Display and Trial Garden. We are at the corner of Fowell Avenue and Gortner Avenue on the St. Paul campus. And it was originally just strictly trial blocks. In 1992, Brad Peterson, who was a professor down at Waseca, moved up here to work and started the landscape design program in our department, and then also started redesigning this garden, not to include trials, but also be a good example of sustainable landscape design.
And what exactly does a Master Gardener do? I mean, kind of, what is their role?
A Master Gardener is first and foremost a volunteer. They're giving their time, they're giving their knowledge, they're sharing it with people who will have a better life because of it, and they're also becoming educated. So they're also connected to the university and learning from university research and bringing that out to Minnesota citizens and showing them how to apply it in their daily lives.
Tell me a little bit about the biochar research project that's going on right now.
The biochar research project is actually part of a bigger bioenergy, biomass project. It's an 8-state USDA-funded grant. Master Gardeners are studying a byproduct of the biofuel generation process called pyrolysis. And I heard a great analogy. It's like a cow. Mm-hmm. You put in feed, you get out milk, and you get out manure. And in the pyrolysis process, you put in a biomass like switchgrass, you get out biofuel, and you get out biochar. And the biochar goes back into the soil as a soil amendment. It's a high carbon soil amendment.
Here we come. Incoming. Whoa, don't you dare.